Castigliano's method is very similar to virtual work, but we apply the load first. The equation is deflection or slope is equal to the sum of the integrals of the moment equation times a partial derivative of the moment equation with respect to the load P taken with respect to X all over those material properties E and I. Just like virtual work, P is going to be a point load for deflection, and it is going to be a moment for slope. So here is our simply supported beam with the two moments applied, where we want to find the slope at A and the deflection at C. Using Castigliano's method, the first thing that we are going to do is apply our load. If we're looking for the slope at A, then I'm going to apply the slope moment load P at A. Then I'm going to solve for my reactions. Making sure I include P in my equilibrium equation, I find that By is 200 minus P divided by 16 acting up. Sorry, I had a sign error, so correcting for my error in By and plugging it into my force Y equation, I get Ay is 200 plus P down. Now that I have my reactions in terms of P, I can take my sections. So I need a section between every time there's a change in load or connection. So I'm going to have section 1 between pin A and my 100 kip foot load. And then I'm going to have section 2 between point C and my 100 kip foot load and my roller B. Setting up my origin X from the left side, I can take my first section, where I'm going to have my reaction Ay. I'm going to have my virtual P, and then I have my internal forces. I find that my moment one equation is equal to P minus 200 plus P over 16 times my distance x1. So expanding this out, I get P minus 200 x1 over 16 minus px1 over 16. When I take the partial derivative with respect to P, I get 1 minus x1 over 16. Plugging P back in, which is really not there, so it's equal to 0, my moment one equation becomes 200 x1 divided by 16. That is a negative. Setting up my section 2, I find that moment 2 is equal to 200 plus P divided by 16 times x2 minus 100. Expanding that out, I get 200 x2 divided by 16 plus px2 divided by 16 minus 100. Taking my partial of moment 2 with respect to P, I get x2 divided by 16. P is really equal to 0. Therefore, moment 2 is really equal to 200 x2 divided by 16 minus 100. Plugging these into my equation for theta A, I have the integral from 0 to 8 feet. You know what? I'm going to move EI to the other side of the equation because it's constant throughout. I have moment 1, which is minus 200 x1 divided by 16. times the partial 1 minus x1 divided by 16 dx1, and then I'm going to add that to x2, which again goes from 0 to 8 feet, but from the other side. My m2 equation is 200 x2 all over 16 minus 100 times x2 divided by 16, taken the derivative with respect to x2. And I find that my slope at A is equal to a negative 333 kilopound feet squared. Then I move my EI back over. That negative sign means that I assume the incorrect direction, so it is actually sloping counterclockwise. For the vertical deviation at C, I'm going to cheat a little bit and copy from what I had done earlier, but you see I removed the moment P, because that's the slope at A, and I'm going to add in instead that point load at C of P. And now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to sum for moments about A. And I get BY to be 200 plus 8P divided by 16, acting up. So then if I sum for my forces in the Y direction, I get AY is minus 200 plus 8P divided by 16. So I'm going to take my same sections that I took before with slope. My moment one equation is minus 200 plus 8p all over 16 times the distance x1. So if I take my partial of m1 with respect to p, I get 0.5 x1, 8 divided by 16 is a half. P is really equal to 0, therefore moment one is really equal to negative 200 x1 divided by 16. I've been leaving all these in fractions because it doesn't bother me, fractions or decimals, but you can certainly use decimals if you would like. Setting up my section two with the new origin from 0 to 8 feet, I have my moment two is equal to negative 100 plus 200 plus 8p all over 16 times the distance x2. Taking my partial of m2 with respect to p, I have again 0.5 x2 because all I'm left with is the 8 16ths. Everything else is a constant that goes to 0. So moment 2, P is really equal to 0, therefore moment 2 is equal to minus 100 plus 200 x2 all over 16. My vertical deflection at C, plugging it into the theorem, and again I'm going to move EI out here, is equal to 0 to 8 feet of minus 200 x1 divided by 16 times 0.5 x1 dx1 plus the integral from 0 to 8 feet of minus 100 plus 200 x2 divided by 16 times 0.5 x2 dx2. And we have the vertical deviation at C is equal to 1600 kip feet cubed all over EI, moving it back over, and I got a negative answer again, which means that it's really acting up instead of my assumed direction down. Let's do a frame this time where we're looking for the horizontal displacement at C. So using Castigliano's method, the first thing I'm going to do is apply my horizontal force here, P, at C. And then I'm going to take my sections. I'm going to need a section here from A to C, and then one from C to the moment, and then another one from C to B. I think I'm going to take U down, U to the right, and U to the right. 1, 2, and 3. All right, so that means I need all of my reactions at A and B. Solving for By in terms of P, I get By is equal to 200 plus 4P divided by 3. Because AY and BY are the only Y forces I have, AY is going to be the opposite, or negative 200 minus 4P divided by 3. AX ends up being 60 plus P. And I could tell all the loads were going to the right, so I knew that AX was going to be the left, so I solved it with AX pointing left. Okay, now with my sections, I'm going to have Y coming from A, and I'm going to have X coming from B. Putting my distributed load in terms of slope, because it changes as I increase my distance Y. So that is rise over run, 15 over 8Y. This is my distance Y. I have AX, which is 60 plus P. I have AY minus 200 minus 4P divided by 3. And then I have my internal forces, shear 1, normal 1, and moment 1. And solving for moment 1, I get 60 plus P times y minus 1/2 of y times 15 over 8y times 1/3 of y. And cleaning that up, I get M1 is equal to 60y plus py minus 5/16 y cubed. Taking the partial derivative of M1 with respect to P, I get Y. P is really equal to 0. Yes, there is a load at C, but it's a distributed load at C, not a point load. So the point load at C is going to be 0. We've already talked about the distributed load with our 5/16 Y cubed. So our moment one equation is actually equal to 60y minus 5/16 y cubed. Section two is just going to have By. And the internal forces, V2, N2, and moment two, acting at a distance of x. Moment 2 is 200 plus 4p divided by 3 times the distance x. Taking my partial derivative of m2 with respect to p, I get 4/3 x. P is really equal to 0, therefore my moment 2 equation is equal to 200x divided by 3. Section 3 represents 3 to 6 meters taken from B. So my 80 kilonewton meter moment is now included, as well as my reaction By. So solving for my moment at 3, I have minus 80 plus 200 plus 4p over 3 times the distance of x. Taking my partial of moment 3 with respect to P, I have 4/3 x. P is really equal to 0. Therefore, my moment 3 equation is equal to 200 x over 3 minus 80. Okay, three sets of equations. Let's plug it in. My horizontal deflection at C is going to equal to the integral from 0 to 8 meters of our y, 60y minus 5 sixteenths y cubed times y dy. And again, I've moved the EI over, so I'm not dividing by it because it is constant throughout the system, plus the integral from 0 to 3 meters of 200 x over 3 times 4 thirds x dx plus my final integral 3 meters to 6 meters of 200 x over 3 minus 80 times 4 thirds x dx, and my horizontal deflection at C is equal to 13,200 kilonewton meters cubed all over EI in 3 significant digits. I ended up with a positive answer, which means it is in fact deflecting to the right.